Well, I think that is probably continued uncertainty. What we've seen in the past several months is that we get some news and investors tend to extrapolate it, and then the news goes the other way. And so what we've tried to focus on as a macro top-down research shop is where the business cycle's going.
Right.
And despite...
And by the way, the slowing in the U.S. economy this year, would you say that's the business cycle ending, or is that the tariffs and the trade issues really hurting the manufacturing sector?
It's both. And I would say it began with the Fed tightening cycle, which started a couple of years ago, and that's playing through the economy, through it hit housing, it hit manufacturing, and it's also seemingly hitting the services sector as well. And so the trade tariff uncertainties is only exacerbating what the Fed had done and is trying to unwind now.
And Jim, I know you see things a little bit. You're more bullish in terms of the market here, I guess. Are you bullish in terms of the economy and our ability to keep weathering this trade uncertainty? It looks like it's going to be with us for some time.
I am, I guess. I think that, I think the answer to the trade uncertainty, I think it's going to be with us for a generation.
Mm-hmm.
I think we're just scratching the surface of economic fights going forward. There's so much capitalism around the world now. Kelly, we've had a huge success in the last 30 years spreading capitalism and getting everyone with skin in the game, if you will, so much so that they really can't use military options anymore. It's too costly, so you're left with economic options. And I think we're just going to get used to having economic battles like this going on as a regular deal. And I really think that the trade impact is small on the United States economy. I concur with Mike that the bigger impact in my book is the tightening that went on last year, not only in our Federal Reserve, not only by our bond market, but by bond markets all over the globe that rose in yield and with about a one-year lag slows us down. I think we're entering the period now where the easing that took place since late last year across the globe is just now ending the period where it should start to get better. And we are seeing some of that in better economic surprise indices, not only here in the United States, but in a lot of places around the globe,
Michael,
including
do you think that
in the emerging markets and in China.
Do you think that monetary juice that Jim refers to is going to play through in the economy?
Sure. We're certainly seeing the green shoots of that. After the Fed's last rate hike, if we fast forward to the middle of this year, we're starting to see money supply growth in the U.S. pick up. We're starting to see housing strength stabilize. Those are the early signs of an easing cycle that you want to see. That'll help grow your conviction in towards whether the benefits will broaden out to the broader economy, and we're seeing that.
But ironically, you're still defensively posturing for
yes.
the market.
So, yeah.
So you're bullish but defensively posturing. Jim, you're saying you'd buy financials and energy and tech and everything here. Is that right?
I would, Kelly. I think that it's fine to own some defensive stocks, but I'd be underweight. I think they're just way too popular, way too bid up in price, way too overvalued. And if we get any recovery at all, we don't need a huge fast growth rate, just a bounce in any kind of manufacturing data. I think there's going to be quite a rally in cyclical stocks
okay.
that are very underrepresented in portfolios, and just a little bit of bearish thinking moving back in that direction could lead to big upside moves.
Michael, quick last response on that.
Sure. We've been overweight groups like utilities, staples, and REITs for over a year and a half, and we've been hearing that same pushback. They're expensive. They're
right.
crowded. The bottom line is when we do see that monetary stimulus help pick up leading indicators like PMIs, that will be the time to get out of those groups. We think
you're not afraid you're going to get trampled with the herd if you wait for those signs?
We think it's still 3 to 4 months away. We're watching closely,
okay.
but with earnings season coming, we still think there's some downside risks.